Hello students, so now we are going to discuss the different kinds of nuclear cross section. So here you can see the different kinds of nuclear cross section are the total nuclear interaction cross section, the partial cross sections and the differential cross section. So the total nuclear cross section would be the contribution of all type of cross sections that the target nuclei would be encountering, and it is the sum of all types of cross sections, and the all type of cross sections would be coming under the head of the differential cross sections. So adding all the differential and the partial cross sections will result into the total interaction nuclear cross section. So let's study what is the total interaction nuclear cross section. So as you have studied that the cross section means that the effective area which the target nucleus provides to the incident particle for a nuclear reaction to occur. So it is effective area that the target nucleus possess for removing the particle from the incident beam. So when the incident beam strikes the target nucleus, that incident particle is removed and it is effective in carrying the nuclear reaction. So the incident particle, when it is removed, and such type of processes may be of different types. So different type of processes which could happen could be the scattering, absorption or a nuclear reaction. So the scattering, absorption, nuclear reaction comes under the head of the partial cross sections. So in the total nuclear cross section, it depends upon the kinetic energy of the incident beam, that whether which type of reaction will occur, whether it would be scattering, it would be absorption, it would be nuclear reaction, what type of reaction would be there, it depends upon the incident kinetic energy. And it also depends upon the nature of the incident beam, whether the incident beam is considering of proton, neutron, alpha particle, and what type of reaction will take place. And third, as I have already listed, that the total nuclear cross section is the sum of all the partial cross sections. So now we study what are partial cross sections. So under the head of partial cross section, as we have studied, that the process could be a scattering process could be absorption process or any nuclear reaction process. So all these processes are the partial cross section. So how does it depend that it could be a scattering process, it could be absorption process? So it depends upon the fact that if the incoming particle and the outgoing particle are same, if they are same, means X plus Y reacts to form Y plus again X. So if the particles are same, incoming particle and the outgoing particle is same, then we say that the scattering process is taking place. And similarly, if the outgoing particle is different than the incoming particle, then we say that the absorption has taken place. And then for that cross sections, we say that in the first case it would be scattering cross section, and in the second case it would be absorption cross section. And in the absorption cross section, we normally deal with the radiative capture, where the radiation has been captured by the target and some other particle has been removed. So that leads to the absorption cross section. So the scattering cross section is denoted by sigma SC, and the absorption cross section is denoted by sigma A. So the total nuclear interaction cross section will be sigma total, which is the sum of the scattering cross section and the absorption cross section. So the cross section for any particular reaction will be equal to, that is the sigma will be equal to the number of given type of events that take place in a unit time in a particular nucleus. So it is number of given type of events per unit time per unit nucleus, and it depends upon what was the incoming. So it depends upon the number of projectile particles per unit area per unit time. So the cross section is given by the number of given type of events that occurred, that happened, divided by the total number of events or the total number of the projectiles that were targeted to the target nucleus. So if we say that the incoming beam had n particles, small n particles per unit volume or per unit centimeter cube, and the particles were moving with the velocity of v, then the n into v will be the particle flux, that how much particle is reaching the target nucleus and be hitting the target, and the target is consisting of n nuclei per centimeter cube or n nuclei per unit volume, and the target is having thickness t. Then the cross section will be given by how many collisions the target encounter. So it will be collisions per square centimeter per second divided by the number of projectiles, that is nv. Nv is the flux, particle flux, into n is the number of target into time. So we get that sigma will be collisions per square centimeter per second upon nv into nt. From these value, by substituting all these values, we can calculate the cross section of any reaction. Either it could be scattering, it could be absorption, or a nuclear reaction. So if we consider the third type of the nuclear cross section, that could be the differential cross section. So differential cross section means a smaller cross section which is encountering a nuclear reaction. So here is a figure. So we have seen that this is a particular small circle which is encountering a nuclear reaction where the incident beam is hitting, and when we integrate over the smaller region, it gives a total differential cross section. So incident beam is coming and hitting the target, where this small region is the effective, that is the d sigma, and it is dependent upon the angles, that is the theta and the phi angles. So d sigma theta phi is the differential cross section, and we integrate it to get the total differential cross section. And here in the differential cross section, since we have to consider it for the angle thetas and phis, so we are taking into account not only angle theta or a phi, we are taking into account the angle of solid angle. So here you can see this is the solid angle, and when the incident beam strikes and the outgoing particle is to be registered by the detector. So we have kept a detector here where we can see that how many particles are coming out or how many nuclear reactions are taking place. So what is there? So the differential cross section can be depicted as sigma theta phi, which is d sigma theta phi, the smaller area, d sigma theta phi upon d omega, when d omega is the solid angle. Everybody know that the solid angle can be represented as sine theta d phi. When we integrate the total solid angle, we get the value of 4 pi. So sigma theta phi into d omega is equal to d sigma of theta phi. So this value will give the probability that the outgoing particles are confined to solid angle d omega, that the outgoing particle will be in a particular angle, and that angle is not a simple angle, it would be a solid angle d omega, and the d omega will be in a direction of theta with the incident beam. It is an angle of theta, where theta can take the value of 0 to pi, 0 to 180 degree theta can take the value, where the phi can take the value of 0 to 2 pi. It could be either in the clockwise or in the anti-clockwise direction. So the phi depends upon the spin of the independent beam, where the independent beam is polarized in which direction. So phi can assume a value of 0 to 360 degree, where theta assumes a value of 0 to pi. So the phi dependence hold good when incoming beam of particles is polarized, that is having spins directed in a particular plane. So the total cross section, if we want to calculate, we integrate the above equation. So sigma theta phi into d omega, where we substitute the value of d omega as sine theta d phi. And the phi can take the value from 0 to 2 pi, and theta assumes the value from 0 to pi. So when the spins are independently oriented, so we do not have any dependence of phi on this sigma term. So d phi integral is independently carried out, and the value is 2 pi. So for d phi integral, we have the value of 2 pi. So we have left with only one integral, that is for theta. So we get 0 to pi d sigma, and the cross section also has a dependence on only theta term. So it is d sigma theta sine theta d theta. So putting the values of your thetas, so we can calculate the value of the differential cross section. So in this way we have three types of cross sections. First is the total cross section, next was the partial cross section, and the differential cross section. So adding all types of cross sections, we get the effect of the total nuclear interaction cross section. So the cross section is an area that the target incident particle is striking at the area of the target nucleus, which is effective in carrying out the nuclear reaction. So the units of the cross section are the units of area, and for the cross section units we have listed a special term, that is barn. So 1 barn is 10 raised to power minus 24 centimeter square. Since centimeter square is the unit of area, so 10 raised to power minus 24 centimeter square is equivalent to 1 barn. So this barn, we measure the cross section in terms of barn. So I hope that you have understood the different types of cross sections and the unit of cross section too. Thank you.